to Escape to Gaming. My name is Dean Thompson. Many of you may be wondering, well, who the hell is this guy? Is he a gamer or what? Well, I'm a kid that grew up in the 60s and 70s. If you ever saw the movie Dazed and Confused, you know, it gives you a rough idea of the time period and the good times that we had. I mean, literally, there was a lot of that. You're driving around your friend's brother's car, going to arcades, playing pool. When we weren't, going out seeing Jaws or queuing up at a Kiss concert or something, we were at the arcades. That's pretty much where we lived. A lot of pool, a lot of arcade games, which I sucked at the time, but I had a good time there anyway. I just loved being in frankly, the whole environment. I remember Pong came out, an incredible game. At the time, we were kind of watching a lot of sci-fi films in the early 70s. That was kind of, we knew that was the future. It was going to be electronics and computers and all that, so anything that was electronic or new, we all loved it and jumped on it. We thought it was the greatest thing since sliced bread. I mean, literally. So it was a great time to be alive as a gamer. So, early on, we had the Atari 2600. Of course, I begged my parents for one. It just wasn't going to happen. They just didn't have the money. And quite often, I'd open a bunch of gifts up, and they'd be Stratego or Battleship or Monopoly. And, oh, thanks, And I wasn't thrilled about it, but that's the way it was. So what I did is I went to Plan B, which is to work on my mom all week so I could spend the night at my friend's house and play his Atari 2600, which frankly was just as good because then I could really kind of let my hair down over there where I had a little bit more strict rules at my mom's house. So that's what we did. And we'd go over there and ride my bike over and spend all night playing the 2600. We played Dig Dug, Breakout, I remember, and my favorite, in fact, my buddy's favorite too, was Dodging. We loved that one. Just we felt like we were street racers racing toward each other and colliding and we'd stop long enough to play, to watch Starsky and Hutch on TV and then go right back to playing for another 3-4 hours till 4 or 5 in the morning, sleep, and then get up, have breakfast, and, we'd try to play the games again, then the parents would kick us out, get out and ride your bike or something. So that was the end of that. At this point, we had, the crash in the 80s, with E.T. and a lot of other, frankly, god-awful 2600 games that you'd try to play them, you'd try to squeeze all the fun out of them, but they frankly weren't much fun, so time passed. I got my first console finally, the Commodore 64 of all things. Other people had the NES, and I loved playing Duck Hunt, Mario Brothers, and Donkey Kong and those. But I liked some of the simulations that they had on the Commodore 64. Silent Service, Airborne Rangers, Paperboy, Spy vs. Spy. These were all the games that I loved on the Commodore 64, and I had to spend a lot of money on those games. A little bit later on, I got the Super NES, which was fantastic. I mean, I think I bought it. My friend had Wing Commander. I loved the game. I felt like I literally was in a Star Wars film. And then Super Star Wars came out right after that. I remember buying that one and loved it. I could never quite finish it, but man, I worked awfully hard at trying to drive as much enjoyment as I could out of it. Syndicate was another game I enjoyed on it. Mortal Kombat, Star Fox, and then another one was kind of a Mad Max game, Outlander, which I loved. Horrible game. The controls were god-awful, but I had a lot of fun with it. So at this point, now all of a sudden, we're watching MTV now. This is the late 80s, kind of going into the early 90s. And quite often on Friday nights, I started seeing these ads pop up for it was a Panasonic 3DO. Very expensive. And I just had to have, the commercials were mind-blowing. I mean, I said, this is it. The future has arrived. I really thought that it was the most immersive thing that was out there. And from that point on, I said, okay, the Super NES is nice, but I want more. And I could, at the time, PC games were very expensive. A PC could cost you $4,000 or $5,000 very easy for a starter, which you might pay $300 or $500 for one today. So that was out. So, am I going to pay, $850 for the Panasonic 3DO or more? Or what could I do? So I started saving my money for it. Not long after, a few months later, I still was saving up to buy one, and I started seeing the brand new PlayStation commercials. And I said, you know what? This is affordable. This is right now. So I actually remember I got my first big paycheck from a job that I did. I went down. It was $729 for the first PS1, two controllers, a memory card, and a couple games. I had Road Rash, Agile Warrior, and Twisted Metal. Awesome games. I mean, to this day, they're still some of my favorite gaming memories. My wife at the time absolutely loved to play Road Rash. We'd take turns fighting over the controller. Tons of split-screen with my friends playing Twisted Metal. Later, I started playing more like the Duke Nukem Time to Kill third-person shooter with the Duke. Awesome. By then, around the same time I did get a PC, started playing Doom, played Duke Nukem 3D, because I liked the time to kill so much, and a little bit of Quake, and I loved the game Myst. Myst was a fantastic, submersive experience, almost a religious experience, if you can believe it. So at this time, now, the PS2 comes out. Now, I'm really excited. I'm intrigued that they could even get even more advanced than what we've been playing on the PlayStation. Well, I went out and bought it just to get Twisted Metal Black. Still to this day, one of my favorite games. I mean, I love playing as every character, every car. I probably played it for virtually 4 months straight before I even bought any other games. Not long after, I ended up getting Grand Theft Auto 3, which was fantastic. Manhunt was an intense game. I loved it. I had a buddy of mine who'd come over, we'd stay up all night at these just intense Manhunt sessions. It's one of the first cover-based shooters that I actually played, where it's a shooter and it had a lot of melee stuff. So I loved that game. Vice City, Medal of Honor Frontline. Beautiful. Very submersive. This is around the time of Saving Private Ryan. I really enjoyed that game. Test Drive. Test Drive Off-Road. These are all games I played. Wolfenstein Return to Castle quickly became my most submersive, intense all-nighter game ever. I played it on medium. I replayed it on hard. Loved it. Beat it. Then I saw a commercial for a PC and Xbox game called Land of the Dead Road to Fiddler's Green. One of the worst games on Metacritic, frankly. But I loved it. It was my first real survival horror since the first Resident Evil on the PlayStation, which I also loved and played. So I bought it and damn near had a psychotic episode playing it. It was so intense with the creepy electronic music and the sound of the zombies. Loved that game. Forza 1 was one of the first major, really polished driving games that I enjoyed in that console. From Russia with Love, I loved Freedom Fighters. These were all great games on the Xbox. Now we're pretty much currently up to this time. It wasn't really until well after the price had dropped down a little bit on the Xbox 360 that I jumped on board. So that's where I'm at today. So now, you know, you pretty much, I've kind of caught you up to speed just to kind of give you a little flavor and taste of where I am, where I come from as a gamer, what I played, what my favorites were. I mean, I could elaborate virtually for hours on just some of the wonderful all-night sessions I had. Great times with friends. I mean, frankly, the PS One alone. I mean, we had so much partying and fun just around that system with the split-screen games at the time. It was incredible. So this is a great time to be a gamer. Today, the games that we have are incredible. So I'm going to be bringing more of these shows over time. I just thought that I would take the time to kind of let you know who I am, what I'm about, what I'm looking forward to. I want to do shows on rants, my feelings. I have a lot of strong feelings and impressions on games. Maybe I'll take some time and talk about some of my reflections over time, talking about some of my favorites. I certainly have a lot of feelings about the jaded gamer today and board gamers, so I want to go over that as well. There'll be gaming reviews of games that I like as well, so stay tuned. If this is something that you like, by all means support it. I really appreciate you watching the show. Thank you so much. Again, my name is Dean Thompson. To me, gaming is a wonderful way of escapism. And I want everyone to enjoy it, no matter what the genre is. It just really is a wonderful time that we live in. I've never had it so good. If I could go back in a time machine from back then and even see what was coming, I would have probably had a heart attack. This is a great time to be a gamer. So enjoy your games, have fun by all means, and I'll look forward to you in the next episode. I'm Dean Thompson. Thanks.